Hello everybody, welcome back to Let's Play Victoria 3 as Italy. Let us continue on from where we last left off. So, me, Prussia, and Russia have all decided to gang up on the Austrians, and it's going pretty well, I would say. I mean, Austria, I don't know how much money they have. I'm assuming they're going pretty bankrupt. Worst part right now is at zero. Dead. I mean, they haven't lost that many. Like, we've lost... It's about equal, all things considered. Are we going to win this fight? It looks like we will. So, I mean, we're pushing our way closer and closer towards Vienna here. So, I'm very, very happy to report that. Another battle. Apparently, Prussia's actually here to support us. I'm not going to say no to that. If they want to give me some support, I am more than willing to take it. I will say the Russians haven't performed very, very well. How many men have they lost? 95,000. 38,000 from battle. Does it say who they lost him towards or against? No. But the more Austrians we kill... I mean, if we actually win a war, I don't know if that's going to completely, like, destabilize Austria. We can maybe see it break apart a little bit. Disappearing interest in Persia. We only have 5 interests? Are we no longer? We're still a great power. I'm surprised that we're having that issue. By the way, how's our colonization game going? 39 days here, 4 and 23. We'll see. It's not going super well in South Africa. But it's not terrible either. We're going to take over more. I mean, yeah, it's pretty bad right now for Austria. They're at negative 45. Negative 54. Very soon they will surrender. And we're going to be getting all of our lovely war goals. They don't want to say yes to... They would say yes to 2 things. They won't say yes to everything quite yet. But by God, we'll get there. Electricity generation. Do we have anything that improves my universities? I know that there is... Yeah, no, analytical philosophy, I think, is like the last upgrade for that, and it's way down there. But negative 5% bureaucracy. You know, let's take you. We do have 75 bureaucracy. What do I want to do? I mean, I don't know if we can actually do too much with it. And we still have not passed the health insurance law. I mean, I'm sure it's almost ready to go. 8 against 17. So we will lose this battle, but that's not a huge deal. Austria win another battle up towards the north. As you can see, you know, like, all of Austria is now more or less ready to revolt. I mean, Germany's not doing so hot either. There's a lot of revolts happening right now. People are not super happy with the way that the war is going. And I completely understand, because I would say the war is going very, very bad for you. Monarchy. Okay, no, we don't want to pass any laws. These are now unproductive. Is there anything expensive? Not really, actually. Like, we're overall doing pretty well. Do we have anything that we can export? No, not really, actually. We have nothing that's, like, super good to export. Details. Well, let's look at our pops. Which is, there should be, like, a detail list to tell you, like, what their needs are. I've seen people talk about their needs. But I don't know where to actually look at that. Standard of living's at 14. You're politically inactive. Well, what are we paying, like, a lot of money for? Liquor, wine, opium, clothes. Let's open up a clothes. How much would you drive the price down? Basically cut that in half. Yeah, so let's import some clothing. Opium. Well, right now we don't have a use for opium because we don't have the hospitals yet. Groceries are also pretty expensive. Let's import some groceries from France. Wine, liquor, you're very expensive. People really want liquor. And you know what? We'll import that from France as well. 25,000 pounds from tariffs. Even though we're in free trade, so again, we don't have tariffs. Maybe we should get rid of free trade so we can start reincorporating tariffs into the economy. So Tyrol's been conquered. Venezia, Lombardy. Okay, this does lead to a terrible-looking Austrian here, but we'll take over this territory soon enough. Questionable practices. Released patients of Naples Asylum have sadly denounced the practices involved in their supposedly medical treatments. Negative 10% bureaucracy for 5 years. You can spend a lot of money on this. Or we just get negative 2 for... Yeah, fuck the trade unions. They don't matter right now. But the war has been won. I do think we do need to incorporate these states. So yeah, let's get you incorporated. Let us incorporate you. You'll probably cost us a little bit of money for now, but that shouldn't last too long. Get us 2 new generals. 1 flotilla in reserve. We'll recruit you. Low market access to these areas in the north. We'll figure that out as time goes on. And now you're unproductive. I'm assuming because we're no longer at war, we're not importing a ton of ammunition or weapons into the country. Insufficient taxation capacity in Piedmont. Inactive trade routes in Prussia. And our new territories are currently under high tension, but that should, I think, start to trickle down, hopefully. More enactments, 20 prestige, 20, you know what? We're at 51%, just give me a flat 20 prestige boost. I know it doesn't really do too much, but I'm happy to have it. So we need to own more than 14. I think we own exactly 14 right now. We either need to take Self-Tyrol or we can take Istria. One of those two has to fall to us. Also, Prussia, we now actually have a direct border with you, so we shouldn't need to use convoys anymore to trade. South Africa. So you can start colonizing more. Let's colonize here. 50 days on you. You know, just abandon the colony down south. Let's not even worry about here. Clear interest, remove our interest in the south. Gonna put it back in Egypt. We might want something from the Egyptians at some point. I mean, construction's still good, 141. Honestly, we can probably afford to build more. We'll either build more or we get our whip to steel frame buildings. One of the two. And also, one thing I did say that we were going to do is upgrade our universities. Can I upgrade actually any of you? Furniture manufacturers, mechanized workshops, absolutely. Paper mills, paper bleaching, arms industry, rifles, and smooth bores. Shipyards, we're still fine kind of splitting them up. Actually, are we? Yeah, upgrade you to be better military shipyards. That seems fine for now. Munition plants, filing cabinets, philosophy departments. And for you, 100% staffed. I mean, Campania, put us straight up to level 15. And then in buildings, constructions. For all the universities at the very, very top. It'll be done in 15 weeks. It costs 300, which actually is not that bad. Now we're spending 300 or 34,000 pounds. Construction goods are expensive. Subsidies, military wages. We've got more crises breaking out. You want to cut Austria down this... Oh, poor Austria, man. Oh, because they're over 100 infamy. Currently, we're at 50. I know what over 100 infamy is when they cut down the cost of, cut down the size cost of belly can happen. So the British are just going to... Belgium's already on their side. I can't join the war, obviously, because, hey, we were just at war with Austria. But the British are going to come in here. And they're just going to beat up Austria, just for the fun of it. And you know what? I welcome that. Because if Britain and Austria go to war, we will eventually be able to go back, take either Self-Tyrol or take Istria. Or both, actually. Because when does my cost of belly end, or my truce end with you? In 67. Okay. So yeah, I think it's a classic 5 years. The Ottomans are now backing you. And there's also war maybe going on in Prussia. I mean, Russia actually is good. Russia and Prussia, old allies. They were literally just fighting in a war together against the Austrians. They're now deciding to both gang up and fight each other. And you know what? So be it. That's not my prerogative. Where do we want to get our next influence? Turkey. You know, let's go North Africa. Because we might actually have some interest in maybe pushing it away and taking over more of the Mediterranean. Like, you will never accept becoming a protectorate, but what if, like, we annexed you? You know what I mean? The paper is once again very expensive. We're the number one producer, and yet we still do not have enough of it. Incredible. You'll drive price down by about 33%, so let's get that going. We have low market access in our northern areas. So right now, we can get road maintenance up here. I'm going to remove it from these areas. Emilia and Lombardy don't have enough. So Emilia, Lombardy is good. Don't have enough in Tuscany. And we don't have enough... Well, these two, we really can't do anything about it right now. And you're in turmoil. Like, why are you so mad? Migration, traction, infrastructure. But, like, why are you pissed off? Like, I know you didn't like being under Austria. 184 population. But, like, what are they mad about? Fences, turmoil 56. From Radical Pops. So we just inherited a ton of angry people. It looks like they're slowly being unradicalized. De-radicalized? I don't know exactly how you'd want to phrase it. So there's going to be massive wars going on in Central and Eastern Europe. And that's fine. Completely okay. I have no interest in backing any side here. So Austria, you guys can fight the British. Prussia and Russia, you can fight amongst each other. So be it. Battle for Ulm. Why does it a picture of a little anchor? Well, I don't really know. But I guess Britain can actually send a lot of units into, like, Bosnia now. It's an interesting war for sure. And interesting stuff's going on over there. How long until this tech is done? Identification documents. I think what we want to do is I want to actually... 17 months to be steel frame buildings. I want steel frame buildings so that we can upgrade our construction sector more. And we can start building like a lot of excellent stuff. Because right now, what is our innovation at? 117, we've definitely been increasing it by... Yeah, we should have been upgrading these universities way sooner. I wonder how much like innovation other countries are generating. I don't know if we can actually see that anywhere. But innovation is good. Prussia is winning their war against Russia. I don't know if Russia can really do anything. And who do we want to win this? Well, the question is, like, who actually likes us? Loyalists, mostly in the south. Radicals are basically all up here in the north. But they'll eventually come around to this. Standard of living is pretty good. It's impoverished up in the north, but everywhere else in Italy is looking pretty good. But what I want to look is not states, country's attitude. So you are a potential friend. Form an alliance. How much? Negative 18? Oh, an obligation? Yeah, me and France. Let's get an official alliance between us. So that's attitude, relations, you mostly don't... I don't know why Prussia hates us so much. Genuinely, I don't know what me and Prussia have ever done in the past. But me and France, we can be good friends. Also, you guys have a shortage of engines. You've got a shortage of engines. Shortage of engines. Okay, so we need more engines now. Let's import you... First from France... Second from the British. Will that solve our issue? It looks like it will at least a little bit. And then after this, we probably want to upgrade. Textile mill should be on top level. And we want to upgrade our motor industry. Right now it's at level 4. Was there anywhere we can build it that would generate a nice profit? Revenue says nothing, but we have a bonus here, so I guess we'll just upgrade you. Throw you straight up to 20. seems pretty good. And when are you going to be done? You're going to be done in 14 months. So a little bit more than a year, we'll get steel frame buildings. Our construction at that point should basically go through the freaking roof. Okay, and Prussia just annexed Württemberg. Well, actually, they subjugated Württemberg. They still exist. They're now just a little puppet. Can you form Germany yet? You've got to be close. Like, you don't have Hanover quite yet, so maybe Prussia's still waiting on a few things. I mean, they have Tyrol as well, and that does count as a state towards Germany. A leader of the armed forces openly preaching about the benefits of a serious and secret political gamble to bring our government... or bring to our government. Do you have a 50-50 chance of success? You know what? Bring me the 50-50. We love 50-50s. And actually, if we have a shortage of motor industries, we probably should throw that to the top of the list. Because right now, we have 293 weeks. How long is that? 293 weeks over 52 weeks in a year. 5.5 years to build everything that we're actually currently have under construction. Failure. Good work. Good work, team. You will step down. Lose authority. Well, right now, you're a moderate, huh? You have no stance on anything? Take the blame. Step down. And how long until you tick? January 2nd? So next month, we'll be able to see if whether or not we can actually pass this health insurance bill. I feel like it's been going on for years at this point. I don't know if I may be exaggerating a little bit, but it feels like it's been quite a while. So how is your war going, Austria? Dead. I mean, this is mostly the British dead. The Ottomans have probably been taking heavy casualties. You're actually, okay, I guess this has to involve everybody. I mean, actually, Austria has mostly been bearing the brunt of the conflict. Like, they've lost more than basically everyone else combined. Let's embargo you, just for the fun of it. I mean, this costs 225, that's fine. Let's declare a rivalry on the Austrians, because fuck Austria. We don't like them very much. We have 84,000 pounds. We actually are missing sugar. Well, where is sugar made? We have wheat farms, can produce 6 sugar. We could produce sugar in our own country. Let's just import it. I don't think we need to worry about sugar for now. And it's an input shortage. Not that it's too expensive. Let's import it from the Dutch and France. Hopefully that'll improve our situation there. Low market access in Amelia. Not a huge deal. We have so much cash. Help the farmers. 40%. Yeah, help them out. 10% bonus. We don't need 40%. I mean, we don't need it to be at, what, like 92% chances to pass? Even though it has been a long time. Let me just put it that way. Can we reform this government? Can we, like, kick you out and bring in the intelligentsia or something? No, they hate that, actually. Get out the armed forces. Like, why do you hate this so much? You know? We still got a lot of radicals. The number is going down. Catholic Church landowners and the rural folk don't like it too much. But I do think that at least for right now, this is going to be a good time for us to end this episode. So thank you for watching me, Anthnwam. If you enjoyed, give me a thumbs up. Not doing a thumbs down. You want to see more, subscribe, and goodbye.